हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट टू डिविजन्स ऑफ किंगडम प्लांटी, फर्स्ट ब्रायोफाइट्स एंड सेकंड टेरिडोफाइट्स। यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट फर्स्ट डिविजन दैट इज एल्गी इन डिटेल इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर। नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम सेकंड डिविजन ऑफ किंगडम दैट इज ब्रायोफाइट्स। एक्चुअली ब्रायोफाइट्स दे इंक्लूड various mosses and liverworts that are found commonly growing in moist shade area in hills. So if you have ever visited this hilly region, hill station region, generally on the rocks or moist soil, this type of plants are found. Bryophytes are called amphibia of the plant kingdom because these plants can live in soil but are dependent on water for sexual reproduction. So we can say two type of life forms are found. One is terrestrial, that is they live on soil, and second is for their requirement of sexual reproduction they use water. That's why these two type of lives is observed. That's why they are also known as amphibia. They usually occur in damp, humid and shaded localities. They play an important role in plant succession on bare rocks soil. As you know, at the time of origin of Earth, there was no plant actually at all. And gradually from unicellular to multicellular plant body developed at that time. So gradually this process take place, that is known as succession. Especially regarding plant, it is plant succession. So from aquatic unicellular and from right now we are having so many terrestrial plants, angiosperm, gymnosperms. So this entire process is actually known as plant succession. So this division, bryophytes is plants, they are having important role during this succession process also. The plant body of bryophyte is more differentiated than that of algae. In algae, actually the plant body was very simple, thallus structure. It is thallus-like and prostrate or erect in bryophytes and attached to the substratum by unicellular or multicellular rhizoids. Rhizoids means root-like structure. Actually, they lack true roots, stem or leaves, but they possess root-like, leaf-like or stem-like structure. So in typical plant where this root, stem and leaf structure are observed, similar type of structure is observed here, but actually it is not true structure. That's why it is written root-like, leaf-like or stem-like structure here. The main body or plant body of bryophyte is actually haploid and in nature. It produces gametes, and that's why it is known as gametophyte. Gametophyte means gamete producing structure. That's why gametophyte, producing gametes. The sex organs in bryophytes are multicellular. In bryophytes, male sex organ is called antheridium, and at maturity they produce biflagellated anthrozoids. If we talk about female sex organ, they are known as archegonium. Actually it is flag shaped structure and produce single egg. The anthrozoids are released into water. As you know, for reproduction purpose, actually bryophytes, they require water as a medium where they come in contact with archegonium. So male sex organ come into contact with female sex organ for this purpose. An anthrozoid fuses with the egg to produce the zygote. So anthrozoid fuse the egg, that is structure, resulting structure, that is zygote structure is formed here. Zygote do not undergo reduction division immediately. They produce first multicellular body which is known as sporophyte. Now this term or word, that is sporophyte, it means that spore producing organ, that is spore producing structure, That's why it is known as sporophyte. This sporophyte is not free living but attached to the photosynthetic gametophyte and derives nourishment from it. So we can say for requirement of food or nourishment, this sporophyte structure is dependent on gametophyte phase of bryophyte, and the gametophyte phase is actually photosynthetic. That's why it can carry out photosynthesis process and can food its prepare itself. And this sporophyte phase, it depends for its requirement on gametophyte phase. Some cells of the sporophyte undergo reduction division. Reduction means meiosis division to produce haploid spores. These spores germinate to produce gametophyte. So we can understand this sporophyte phase is actually spore producing phase. After the formation of these spores in favorable environment, they germinate and they produce gametophyte phase. So in the life of plant, these two phases come one after another, that is known as alternation of generation also. Now some importance of bryophytes. Some mosses provide food for herbaceous mammals, birds and other animals. In bryophyte species of sphagnum, actually it's a moss, provide peat that have long been used as fuel, and because of their capacity to hold water as packing material for transshipment of living material. Mosses along with lichens, now you know about very well about lichen, that is plant body having combination of algae and fungi. So mosses along with lichens are the first organism to colonize rocks and hence are great ecological importance here also. They decompose rocks making a substrate suitable for the growth of higher plants. Since mosses form dense mats on the soil, they reduce the impact of falling rain and prevent soil erosion. Actually, like bed sheet, they cover the entire soil surface, moist soil surface, where they grow in their favorable season. And generally during monsoon season, these mosses are everywhere found. Now, two main types of this bryophyte, that is liverworts and mosses. Let's start with liverworts first. The liverworts grow usually in moist, shady habitats such as banks of streams, marshy ground, damp soil, bark of trees, and deep in the woods. The plant body of liverwort is thalloid. Thalloid means having thallus, simple body structure. Example like Markansia. The thallus is dorsiventral and closely appressed to the substrate. The leafy members have tiny leaf-like appendages in two rows on the stem-like structure. In liverworts, actually asexual reproduction takes place by fragmentation of thalli or thallus or by the formation of specialized structure called gamete. Here this term is important. This is actually specialized structure in liverworts for asexual reproduction purpose, that is gamete. Gamete are green, multicellular, asexual buds which develop in small receptacles called gamma cups located on the thalli. So simply if we try to understand, thallus or thalli is a simple plant body structure. Here on this thalli, in favorable condition, small receptacles develop. They are known as gamma cups. And within this gamma cup, this gamete is formed. Actually, it is a specialized structure for asexual reproduction purpose. The gamete become detached from the parent body and germinate to form new individual. So the structure gamete is responsible for asexual reproduction in liverworts. During sexual reproduction, male and female sex organs are produced either on the same or on different thalli. So we can say sometime on same thallus, single structure, both sex organs like male and female develop, or sometime on different thallus, different body structure, one is having male sex organs and another is having female sex organ, it is like that. The sporophyte is differentiated into a foot, seta and capsule. Foot is actually base of this structure, which possess rhizoids or root-like structure. Seta is a axis and capsule is a reproducing structure here. After meiosis, spores are produced within the capsule structure. These spores germinate to form free living gametophytes. So we can say during sporophyte phase, spores are produced and in favorable condition they germinate and they give rise the next stage, next phase, that is gamete producing gametophyte phase. Second type, that is mosses. Predominant stage of the life cycle of a moss is the gametophyte, which consists of two stages. Now which are these two stages? First stage is the protonema stage, which develops directly from a spore. It is a creeping, green, branch and frequently filamentous stage. So this is known as first stage, protonema stage. Now next, second stage, that is leafy stage. Actually it develops from the secondary protonema as a lateral bud. They consist of upright, slender axis bearing spirally arranged leaves. That's why it is known as leafy stage. They are attached to the soil through multicellular and branch rhizoids. This stage bears the sex organs. So in mosses, these two stages, protonema stage and leaf stage, develop. In mosses, vegetative reproduction take place by fragmentation and budding in the secondary protonema. In sexual reproduction, the sex organs like antheridia, male sex organ, and archegonia, female sex organ, they are produced at the apex of the leafy shoots. After fertilization, the zygote develops into a sporophyte consisting of a foot, seta and capsule structure. Now you know very well about this. The sporophyte in mosses, it means spore producing structure, is more elaborated than that in liverworts. The capsule contains spores. Spores are formed after meiosis process. The mosses have an elaborated mechanism of spore dispersal. Common example of some mosses are Funaria, Polytrichum and Sphagnum, that we are going to study in detail in figure also. Now let's study the figure showing some bryophytes. Here you can see ABCD structure in figure. Let's start first with A. In bryophytes, A is actually liverwort. Here example of Markensia is given in figure. In figure A, it is female thallus and figure B, that is male thallus. In figure A of Markensia, you can see this female thallus which possess archegoniophore, which develop female sex organ, gamma cup. We have already discussed what is it. It is also observed clearly here. So thallus structure is actually leaf-like structure, and below it the rhizoids, root-like structure, develop. In B figure, that is Markansia male thallus. Here, similar type of thallus is observed, but the main difference is observed here in female thallus. Okay, archegonia for develop for female sex organ development, and in male thallus, anthridium for develop for male sex organ development. In C figure, you can see the structure of funaria. Funaria is a typical structure of this bryophyte mosses. Here in this structure, two phases of their life, sporophyte and gametophyte, is clearly observed. The below one is gametophyte and upper one is sporophyte phase. In sporophyte spore producing phase, you can see here the structure capsule. Within this capsule, through meiosis, spores are formed. Ceta is clearly observed. In gametophyte phase, green leaves are observed. This structure possesses main axis and rhizoids also. In B figure, we can study the sphagnum. This gametophyte phase. Sphagnum is also one type of bryophyte. The structure of sphagnum here, like typical plant or tree, some branches are observed. They are having tiny, small size leaves here. Two type of branches are observed. Archegonial branch for female sex organ development and anthridial branch for development of male sex organs here. So this all figures, they show structure of bryophytes like Markansia, both female and male thallus. Then funaria, its gametophyte and sporophyte clearly observed here. And the sphagnum is gametophyte phase. Now third division of kingdom planting, that is pteridophyte. This pteridophyte include horsetails and fronds. These are typical example of pteridophytes. They are used for medicinal purpose and as soil binders also. They are also frequently grow as ornamental plants in garden. Evolutionary, they are the first terrestrial plants to possess a vascular tissue like xylem and phloem. So before pteridophyte, no plant it was having such a type of vascular tissue, xylem for conduction of water and minerals, and phloem is a type of vascular tissue responsible for conduction of prepared food in plant, that we are going to study in detail in chapter 6. The pteridophytes are found in cool, damp, shady places, though some may flourish well in sandy soil conditions also. In bryophytes, the dominant phase in the life cycle is the gametophyte plant body, that is main phase. But if we talk about pteridophyte, the main plant body is actually sporophyte, which is differentiated into two: root, stem and leaf. When we talk about bryophyte, it was like root like, stem like and leaves, but not true structure. But here main difference between bryophyte and pteridophyte, here the structure is actually differentiated into true root, stem and leaves. These organs possess well differentiated vascular tissues. The leaves in pteridophyta are small. They are known as microphylls, as in Selaginella, or large, known as macrophylls, as in fronds. So two type of leaves are observed here: small leaves, microphylls, and large leaves, macrophylls. The sporophytes bear sporangia. Sporangia means spore producing organ, that are substanded by leaf like appendages which are called sporophylls. In some cases, sporophylls may form distinct compact structures called strobili or cones. The structure is typically in some plants is known as strobili or cone. Some example of these plants like Selaginella and Equisetum. The sporangia means spore producing organ produce spores by meiosis in spore mother cell. The spores germinate to give rise to inconspicuous small but multicellular free living mostly photosynthetic thalloid gametophytes which is known as prothallus. These gametophytes require cool, damp, shady places to grow. Because of this specific restricted requirement and the need for water for fertilization purpose, the spread of living pteridophytes is limited and restricted to narrow geographical regions. So their requirement like this above we have explained, and actually specifically water is also required for fertilization process here. So the limited region show this type of variety of plant. The gametophyte phase here where male and female sex organs, they are known as antheridia and archegonia. Water is required for transfer of antherozoids, which are male gametes, released from antheridia to the mouth of archegonium. Fusion of male gametes with the egg present in the archegonium result in the formation of zygote here. Zygote thereafter produces a multicellular, well-differentiated sporophyte, which is the dominant phase of the pteridophyte. So here we can say about pteridophytes, the spore producing sporophyte phase is main phase or dominant phase, and on this phase the gametophyte phase is dependent, that is secondary phase. These two phases come in their life cycle one after another, and that's why it is known as alternation of generation. In majority of the pteridophytes, all the spores are of similar type and they are known as homosporous. Genera like Selaginella and Salvinia, which produce two type of spores. Large, they are macro, and small, micro, and they are known as heterosporous. The megaspores and microspores, they germinate and give rise to female and male gametophyte respectively. The female gametophyte in these plants are retained on the parent sporophytes for variable periods. The development of the zygotes into young embryos take place within the female gametophyte in pteridophytes. This event is a precursor to the seed habit, considered an important step in evolution. So we can say gradually from primary structure of plants, zygote development and zygote to embryo development gradually take place. The pteridophytes are further classified into four classes. First, Psilopsida, example Psilotum. Second, Lycopsida, example Selaginella and Lycopodium. Third, Sphenopsida, example Equisetum. And fourth, Pteropsida, examples Dryopteris, Pteris and Adiantum. Now let's study figure showing some pteridophyte plant. Here you can see four type of plants of pteridophyte. First is Selaginella. In structure of Selaginella plant body, clearly you can see true leaves, stem and root, which we can observe in any typical plant. So root, they possess vascular tissues, okay, for conduction of water and minerals. Leaves, they can carry out photosynthesis process, and stem is also present. In B figure, that is Equisetum pteridophyte here, in the structure of Equisetum, we can see here the strobilus or cone-like structure, that is reproductive structure here. Nodes are observed like typical plants, stem axis. The difference or the space between two sequentially arranged nodes, that is internode, is also observed. Some branches we can see here, and root-like structure rhizome is present. In C picture, that is structure of fern. Commonly this fern are actually ornamental plant found in any garden. Its a local example is Nephrolepis hansrach. If you have visited any garden, this structure, this type of pteridophyte plant is oftenly observed there. D figure, that is Salvinia. It's also one type of pteridophyte plant. In the structure of Salvinia, rhizoids, root structure is observed. Axis is also there, that is stem axis, and on this axis leaves develop. So by studying this all figures of plant, Selaginella, Equisetum, Fern and Salvinia from pteridophyte division, now we can get clear idea about their body structure.